Hello friends, welcome back. Let us proceed ahead with the next topic, that is moment of force and Varignon's theorem. So let us first see the moment of a force. Friends, ye tum log ne high school mein bhi padha hai, that is in your 11th and 12th. Moment of a force or torque. Moment of a force is defined as what? The product of the magnitude of the force and the moment m. Okay. So let us consider a force of magnitude F going along this direction. That is the line of action of force F is here. Okay. अगर तुम लोगों को मोमेंट फाइंड करना है अबाउट अ पॉइंट ओ, सो व्हाट यू विल डू, सो ओ इज आवर मोमेंट सेंटर. जिस किसी भी पॉइंट पे यू अबाउट विच यू वांट टू फाइंड आउट द मोमेंट, दैट इज योर मोमेंट सेंटर. सो इन दिस केस ओ इज आवर मोमेंट सेंटर. वी विश टू फाइंड द मोमेंट ऑफ फोर्स ऑफ दिस फोर्स एफ अबाउट द पॉइंट ओ. तो हम लोग क्या करेंगे, फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट ओ दैट इज द मोमेंट सेंटर, we will drop a perpendicular on the line of action of this force. Okay, so it will give you some perpendicular distance, that is d. So d is nothing but our moment arm. Okay, that is the perpendicular distance between the line of action of force from the moment center. Okay, so by definition moment of a force is equal to f into the moment arm, that is d. Now how will you read this, friends? We will read moment of the force F about the point O. Okay friends, so D is our momentum. Now you have also studied some convention. What is the meaning of convention? Kabhi positive lene ka, kabhi negative lene ka. As per our convention, that is the convention that we will use in our lectures, anti-clockwise moment will be treated as positive and clockwise moment will be treated as negative. Now how do you find out what is the meaning of anti-clockwise and clockwise? Okay friends, so it's very simple. What we will do, one end of the pen we will keep on the moment center, another end pe what we will do, we will apply the force in the direction. Okay, we will apply the force in its direction. So we are going to apply the force in this direction. So tumhara pen kaun se direction mein ghum raha hai friends? It is rotating in the anti-clockwise moment in this case. Okay, so what you will do, keep one end of the pen on the moment center, that is O, then apply the force on the other end in its direction. Direction kaun sa hai ye force ka? Ye direction mein. So apply the force on this end. So how does it rotate? It rotates anti-clockwise. So jab bhi wo anti-clockwise rehta hai friends, we will treat it as positive. Agar wo clockwise nikalta hai to we will treat it as negative. Koi koi books mein ulta bhi rehta hai, it doesn't matter, the answer comes out to be the same. ओके फ्रेंड्स, एंड ऑफ कोर्स उसका ऐसा यूनिट क्या रहेगा, न्यूटन मीटर. ओके, सो नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट इज द वैरिग्नॉन्स थ्योरम. ओके फ्रेंड्स, सो लेट अस प्रोसीड अहेड विद द वैरिग्नॉन्स थ्योरम. वैरिग्नॉन्स थ्योरम क्या बोलता है फ्रेंड्स, द समेशन ऑफ मोमेंट ऑफ ऑल द फोर्सेस अबाउट एनी पॉइंट इज इक्वल टू द मोमेंट ऑफ द रिजल्टेंट अबाउट द सेम पॉइंट. ओके फ्रेंड्स, सो मैथमेटिकली समेशन ऑफ मोमेंट ऑफ ऑल द फोर्सेस अबाउट एनी पॉइंट is equal to the moment of the resultant about the same point. Okay friends, so now consider three forces F1, F2, F3. Their line of actions are in the direction of the arrowheads. Okay, so we want to find out, or we want to use the Varignon's theorem. So we need to find out the moment of each and every force about the point O. So F1 ka moment find out karne ke liye we require the perpendicular distance, that is the moment arm, that is D1. वो कैसे निकालेंगे friends? From the moment center we will drop a perpendicular on the line of action, so we get D1. Similarly we will get D2. Similarly we get D3. Okay, now we will find out the resultant of all these forces F1, F2, F3. Let us say the resultant turns out to be R in this direction. Okay, तो resultant का भी हम लोग क्या करेंगे, we will find out the momentum. So let us drop a perpendicular. So this D is nothing but the momentum. So according to the Varignon's theorem, the summation of moment of all the forces, matlab F1 ka moment about O, F2 ka moment about O, F3 ka moment about O, wo sab ko add karenge, to it will be equal to what? Wo sab forces ka jo resultant hai, uska moment about the same point O. Okay friends, so let us mathematically express that. F1 को पूछो, F1 तेरा मोमेंट क्या है अबाउट O, सो F1 का मोमेंट इज F1 इनटू D1. नाउ विल इट बी क्लॉकवाइज और एंटी क्लॉकवाइज फ्रेंड्स, हाउ डू यू फाइंड आउट? keep your one end of the marker on the moment center, other end pe kya karne ka, direction of force mein usko push karne ka. So F1 is in this direction, so push it. So it rotates anti-clockwise, so that's why it is positive. F2 ko pucho, tera moment kya aega? F2 into D2, okay. Clockwise or anti-clockwise, keep your marker, keep your pen in the direction of force, apply the force on the other end, so it rotates clockwise. So that's why minus F2 into D2. Similarly, F3, it will also be clockwise. So that's why minus F3 into D3 is equal to the moment of the resultant about the same point, that is R into D. Again, resultant ka moment, friends, about the moment center O, it is anti-clockwise. So that's why we have written as positive. Okay, so this is about the Varignon's theorem. We will apply it later on as and when we go ahead with the lectures. Okay, friends.